Ah, not feeling so cocky now, huh? And all it took was for me to go full-on Grizzly Adams. I'd better get out of here before he comes back.
Did you find it?
The legend might be bunk, but the spear is real.
Maybe the legend is also real. Let's hope so, for your sake.
Yeah, the bear is definitely tracking me. You have any luck with the radio?
I did. Did you see the lights in the night sky, the aurora? Well, when that flared up, the radio came to life. Just lit up, Started spitting out noise, but it was all gibberish. Bits and pieces of things. Music. Talking. I think it needs more range. A more powerful signal. If we could find a way to boost the signal strength when the Aurora's active, we might be able to get a message out.
Let me guess. You have an idea.
You're starting to get it, Mackenzie. I was digging through some old geological survey maps.
Those look like military insignia stamped on there.
Focus, Mackenzie! Now, this survey shows a series of radio transponder towers that cross back and forth across Great Bear.
Now, why would those be there?
Good question. But for another time, we can use these.
How?
Each tower has some electronics that'd serve like a signal booster to make sure the message gets to the next relay.
Okay.
Well, you get me two, maybe three of those, and I might just be able to rig us up our own signal booster.
You might, huh? And I guess I need to do this while old Bear decides if I'm going to become the next chapter in his legend?
Don't be silly. Spence's Bear would be long gone by now. That was 150 years ago.
Maybe he has, I don't know, genetic memory.
Ridiculous idea. But there's definitely a bear out there, and he's definitely interested in you. You'll just have to take your chances.
Says the guy safely inside the wooden cabin.
Damn it! You think I want to be in here? I need to get a message out, and this might be the only way.
What message? What does this have to do with me contacting my friend?
There's more at stake than you and your friend! Please, Mackenzie, get me those boosters. I'll fix the radio, and the first call we'll make will be to Perseverance Mills. I promise.
Okay, I'm on it. I'll be back with the transponder parts.
Watch your back, Mackenzie.
What do I have to worry about? I have a legendary 150-year-old demon bear hungry for my blood. Bullets don't stop him, but I'm armed with basically a medieval weapon, which I'm sure will do the trick. I'm stuck in this winter wasteland where lights in the sky make the power flicker and electronics explode, and the only people I seem to meet are all slightly crazy. And this is all after I crashed my plane deep in the wilderness and somehow lost my ex-wife along the way. And I'd really kind of like to find her back.
And don't forget about the wolves.
Let's get on with it. Shit. Looks like someone found trouble. What have we here?
Leave me alone. I'm not opening this door for anyone.
It's okay. I'm not here to take anything from you. Are you with the Forest Talkers?
I am, but I'm not letting you in. They killed my friend. How do I know you aren't one of them?
You don't, but I'm not. Name's Mackenzie, and I'm way too stubborn to just leave you out here all by yourself. You'll have to trust me.
Seems like I don't have much of a choice. We left most of our supplies at the old logging camp while we fished here. Can you get them for me?
I can try.
There's more. In that abandoned dam, we found evidence that proves there shouldn't be logging in Mystery Lake. I need that evidence. Documents nobody wanted to be found. We hid them until we could retrieve them. Under a floor tile at the bottom of the stairwell. If you can help me get the documents back, well, it'd be a huge win for the environment, if you care about it. You know, living in the world.
I have a feeling the world has bigger problems right now, but I'll see what I can do.
Here's the key to the trailer where we stashed our supplies. I'll slide it under the door.
Is it food or